In this lecture, we are going to discuss about different control strategies used to vary the output voltage of a chopper circuit. The average value of output voltage of a DC chopper circuit can be controlled by varying the duty cycle. Duty cycle alpha. Duty cycle alpha is the ratio of on time to the total time period of the chopper circuit. By varying this duty cycle, we can vary the average output voltage of a chopper circuit. Or by varying the switching frequency of the chopper circuit, we can vary the average output voltage of a chopper. There are two types of control strategies employed in a chopper circuit. These are time ratio control strategy, that is TRC. Second one is current limit control strategy. First, we will discuss about time ratio control or TRC control. In this control scheme, time ratio, that is the duty ratio, T on divided by capital T, that is the duty ratio alpha, is varied. There are two types of TRC control. First one is constant frequency operation, and second one is variable frequency operation. There are two types of TRC control. First one is constant frequency control and second one is variable frequency control. First one is constant frequency control. In constant frequency control, the on time T on is varied, but chopping frequency F is kept constant. The chopping frequency in the time ratio control, we are keeping this chopping frequency as constant, that is total time period as constant, and we are varying the T on time. Within the total time period, we are varying the T on time, that is constant frequency system. Variation of T on means adjustment of pulse width as such. The scheme is also called a pulse width modulation scheme. This scheme is also called a pulse width modulation scheme because we are varying the pulse width of the on pulse. In this figure, the chopping period capital T. Chopping period is capital T, or chopping frequency is 1 by T is equal to F, which we are keep that frequency as a constant. We are varying the on time. In first figure, we are keeping this duty ratio alpha is equal to 0.25, and in second case, we are keeping the duty ratio alpha is equal to 0.75. Thus, we can obtain different levels of average output voltage. By varying the duty ratio, we can obtain different average output voltage V naught. When duty ratio is less, average output voltage is less. When duty ratio is high, average output voltage is also high. That is constant frequency control. Second one is variable frequency control. In this scheme, the chopping frequency F is varied. We are varying the chopping frequency. We are varying total time period. Either on time is kept constant or off time is kept constant. This type of control, variable frequency control, is also known as frequency modulation scheme. Variable frequency control, by keeping the on time, we are changing the either the on time constant or off time constant. We are varying the total chopping frequency. We are varying the total chopping frequency, either keeping on time constant or keeping off time constant. That is variable frequency operation. Thus, we can obtain variable average output voltage from a chopper circuit. That is about time ratio control. In time ratio control, we are varying the duty cycle. Time ratio control is of two type: constant frequency control and variable frequency control. In constant frequency control, we are keeping the chopping frequency as a constant, and we are varying on time. But in the case of variable frequency control, we are keeping either on time or off time constant, and we are varying the total chopping frequency. This we can obtain different levels of average output voltage. These are the main disadvantages of time ratio control. The main disadvantages are the chopping frequency has to be varied over a wide range for the control of output voltage in frequency modulation. So filter design for such wide frequency variation is quite difficult. Second disadvantage is for the control of duty cycle alpha, frequency variation would be wide. As such, there is a possibility of interference with the signaling and telephone lines in frequency modulation scheme. Third disadvantage is that the large off time in frequency modulation scheme may make the load current discontinuous, which is not desirable. These are the main drawback of TRC control. Next is current limit control. In this current limit control strategy, the on and off of chopper circuit is guided by the previous set value of load current. These two set values are maximum load current and minimum load current. When load current reaches the upper limit and max, chopper is switched off. Now load current freewheels and begins to decay exponentially. When the load current falls to lower limit I minimum, then the chopper is switched on and the load current begins to rise. Switching frequency of chopper can be controlled by setting I max and I minimum. Current limit control involves feedback loop, the trigger circuit, and the trigger circuitry for the chopper is therefore more complex. PWM technique is also employed in current limit control. In current limit control, we are setting a current limit in between a maximum current and minimum current. When the current flowing through the chopper circuit reaches its maximum value, then the chopper switch turned off, and when the current decays and it reaches a minimum value, the chopper switch turns on. In order to control the chopper switch, the chopper circuit needs a feedback loop and a triggering circuit. Okay, this is about current limit control. These are the two types of control strategies employed in a chopper circuit in order to control the average output voltage from a chopper circuit. The two types of control strategies are time ratio control and current limit control. In time ratio control, we are controlling the duty cycle alpha or switching frequency. There are two types of time ratio control: constant frequency control and variable frequency control. Then in current limit control, we are setting a current limit, a maximum current limit and a minimum current limit. Whenever the current flowing through the chopper exceeds or reaches the maximum current limit, the chopper switches turns off. Whenever the current flowing through the chopper circuit is equal to minimum value of current flowing through the chopper, then the chopper switch turns on. Thus, we can control the average output voltage of a chopper circuit. Okay, thank you.